So today we will talk about Black-Scholes-Merton differential equation. So what is this differential equation? This is a differential equation which must be followed by the prices of all the derivatives on a non-dividend paying stock. Okay, so this must be satisfied or followed by the prices of all the derivatives dependent on a non-dividend paying stock. This non-dividend paying part is important. Okay, so if your stock is paying dividend during the life of that derivative, then you can't use this equation. Of course, this would, you know, as the name is Black-Scholes, this would have an assumption that the stock price process can be modeled via Black-Scholes equation that we have seen earlier. And there are a few more assumptions. So let us first list all those assumptions, and then on the basis of those assumptions we will derive the differential equation. And after deriving the equation, we will see what is meant by a tradable derivative. Okay. So first assumption, of course, is the stock price process follows geometric Brownian motion. The underlying stock price process follows geometric Brownian motion with constant mu and sigma. That is also important. Okay. During the life of the derivative, mu and sigma should not change, with constant mu and sigma. This is first assumption. Second assumption is short selling of securities. Short selling of securities with full use of proceeds is permitted. With full use of proceeds is permitted. Okay, so short selling, I hope everyone remembers what short selling is. You can borrow an asset from someone and sell it. Okay, so that is allowed in the market. And secondly, with full use of proceeds means even if you have borrowed the asset, your commitment is just returning the asset. You don't have to pay any rent or anything, like any commission to the original owner. Okay, whatever you earn by selling that asset, everything can be kept with you. Okay. Third assumption is there are no transaction costs or taxes on transactions. Okay. So no transaction costs or taxes. So again, whatever you sell, every entire amount you earn, and whenever you buy something, you have to pay exactly the price. You don't have to pay anything extra. Fourth assumption is, as I said, non-dividend paying stock. So there are no dividends during the life of the derivative. No dividends during the life of the derivative. You can have in general a stock which pays dividend, but during the life of the derivative there shouldn't be any dividends. Derivative means option or future. So for example, if you are buying or selling an option with, say, expiry time 3 months, then during those 3 months there should be no dividend payable on the underlying stock. Fifth assumption is no arbitrage opportunity. So there shouldn't be any arbitrage opportunity. So riskless profit is not allowed. Okay, there shouldn't be any arbitrage opportunity. We have one more assumption. So sixth assumption is the risk-free rate of interest remains constant throughout the life of the derivative. The risk-free rate of interest remains constant throughout the life of the derivative. Again, the risk-free rate of interest cannot remain stable for years, but during those 3 months, say if you are having an option with expiry 3 months, during those 3 months it shouldn't change. Okay, so these are the assumptions, and on the basis of these assumptions we are going to derive Black-Scholes-Merton differential equation. Now if you recall the theory from binomial tree, we know what we did was we set up a riskless portfolio. Okay, so what we did, we first derived what is the optimal number of derivatives one needs to buy or sell in order to have a riskless portfolio. So we are going to follow the exact same strategy here. Okay, so if you understood the binomial tree derivation, this derivation is exactly similar. So our first job is setting up a riskless portfolio. Setting up a riskless portfolio with position in a derivative and a stock. With position in a derivative and a stock. So, a long short, of course. One is long, the other is short. This is first step. And if the portfolio is riskless, there are two things. First, irrespective of the movement of the stock price, your portfolio worth should remain the same. That is one assumption. And secondly, it should earn exactly the same interest as that of any other risk-free investment. Like, for example, FDs in a bank. Okay, FDs in an established bank. So, in the absence of arbitrage opportunities, because we have already assumed that there are no arbitrage opportunities, so that is our assumption, the return from the portfolio must be same as the risk-free rate of interest. Must be same as the risk-free rate of interest. Okay. So, let us try to do these two steps and that will give us the equation. That's all. Derivation is not at all difficult. So, what do we know? We know that stock price process follows geometric Brownian motion. So, now I am starting the derivation. So, stock price process follows the geometric Brownian motion. So, ds is mu s dt plus sigma s dz. Okay, this we know. And we also know Itô's lemma. So, by Itô's lemma, if f is price of a derivative based on this stock, then it follows this equation, df is equal to dabba f by dabba s mu s plus dabba f by dabba t plus half dabba 2f by dabba s square sigma square s square dt plus dabba f by dabba s sigma s dz. Okay, this is known to us. Now, let us write down the discretized versions of both these equations. So, ds would become delta s. So, delta s is mu s delta t plus sigma s delta z. This is my original geometric Brownian motion equation. And Itô's lemma equation becomes delta f is equal to dabba f by dabba s mu s plus dabba f by dabba t plus half dabba 2 f by dabba s square sigma square s square whole into delta t plus dabba f by dabba s sigma s delta z. Okay, let me call this equation 1, this is equation 2. Now we saw we have to do two steps. First is we have to create a riskless portfolio. Riskless portfolio means irrespective of what is happening in the market, my portfolio worth should remain the same. So even if the market goes up or the down, my portfolio worth should remain the same. See, for things to be riskless, we have to remove the randomness. Okay. If the output is not random, then it means it is not dependent on the market outcomes. Correct. So what is the random factor in these two equations? Delta S is of course modeled by something, but delta S is a function of delta T mu S. So mu is constant, S is constant at a given time point, current price. Delta T means how much change is going to be there in time is fixed. Sigma is constant, S is constant. So the only thing that is random is delta Z. Same story here. Only thing that is random is delta Z. So if we can eliminate delta Z from these equations, then the randomness is gone. And once the randomness is gone, that means that the outcome is fixed. So there is no risk. Okay. So how can we eliminate randomness? We have to eliminate delta Z from these two equations. So of course we'll match the coefficients and then things would get cancelled. Okay. Hence, that is how we set up our portfolio. So our portfolio will consist of short position in one derivative. Okay, we have to decide price of the derivative. So we will say, okay, we are selling the derivative. Short position in one derivative and long position in dabba f by dabba s shares. Okay, if you recall, this is exactly same as binomial tree model. In binomial tree model also we had delta shares here, correct? Dabba f by dabba s was delta, and we had said that if you set up this type of position, then it becomes riskless. Okay, so the derivation goes exactly parallelly to binomial tree. Now this is short position, so minus of this and then plus of dabba f by dabba s. Okay, so you can see here I will have dabba f by dabba s into sigma s here, and then I have already have same thing, so these things would get cancelled. So now let us compute worth of the portfolio. So portfolio worth would be pi equal to minus f, because short position in one derivative, plus dabba f by dabba s into s. Okay, one share is worth s rupees and we are saying we have dabba f by dabba s shares. So we will substitute value of f and s. Okay, so change in portfolio worth, change in portfolio worth would be, again we are going to stick to discretized version, delta pi would be minus delta f plus, this is same because we are not doing any transaction, delta s. Okay, number of shares and number of derivatives is not going to change because we are not doing any transaction in that short duration. And now we will substitute values of delta f and delta s from equations 1 and 2. So that would give me delta pi equal to minus dyba f by dyba s mu s plus dyba f by dyba t plus half dyba 2f by dyba s square sigma square s square whole into delta t minus dyba f by dyba s sigma s delta z plus, so this came from the delta f part and now the remaining part, so dyba f by dyba s times mu s delta t plus dyba f by dyba s times sigma s delta z. So I am just substituting the earlier two equations 1 and 2. Now this dyba f by dyba s sigma s delta z, this gets cancelled with this. So we are left with this dyba s mu s delta t would also get cancelled. So I will be left with only two terms, that is minus dyba f by dyba t. Okay, delta t I can still keep constant. So minus dyba f by dyba t minus half dyba 2f by dyba s square sigma square s square whole into delta t. Okay, this is change in the portfolio worth. Okay, now this is a fixed change. This is not a random change. So irrespective of whatever happens in the market, our portfolio worth is going to change exactly by this amount. Okay, and now we said that the second step in our derivation is the return from the portfolio should be same as the risk-free rate of interest. Okay, so if you want, we can write this again. In the absence of arbitrage opportunity, this return, the return from the portfolio must match the return from the risk-free investment. That is, it should match the risk-free rate of interest. By the way, just because these two signs are minus doesn't mean that my portfolio is declining, portfolio worth is declining, because we don't know anything about signs of dyba f by dyba t and dyba 2f by dyba s square. Sigma square is positive, s square is positive, but these two quantities can be negative. Okay. So what is the return from the portfolio in case of risk-free investment? So pi e raised to rt, r delta t would be the final worth and pi is the original worth. So it becomes pi e raised to r delta t minus 1. Is it okay? So this is because we are assuming risk-free rate of interest. So pi again continuously compounded. So pi e raised to r and the time duration is delta t. Now if delta t is small, then I can use the expansion of e raised to delta t. And then delta t square, delta t cube, all those terms can be ignored because delta t is small. So I'll be left with r delta t, only the first term. Okay. So delta t raised to k for k greater than or equal to 2, ignored. Because my delta t is small, we are talking about small time duration, so we can ignore these things. Okay. And now we are saying that the earlier change in portfolio worth that we computed should match this. Okay, because the portfolio should earn at the same rate as risk-free rate of interest. So delta pi must match pi r delta t. Okay, So let us again substitute delta pi and pi, both these values. So delta pi we have computed above. So let me substitute that value. So minus dab f by dab t plus half dab 2f by dab s square sigma square s square whole into delta t. And in pi r delta t we will put minus f plus dab f by dab s r delta t. Okay, so now we can cancel some things, we can rearrange some things, and what we are going to get is, I'm leaving one step in between for you, it's straightforward step. Dab f by dab t plus rs dab f by dab s plus half sigma square s square dab 2f by dab s square, that would be equal to rf. Okay, so this is known as BSM differential equation for the price of tradable derivatives. So what is meant by this? Every solution to this differential equation would be price of some derivative, some tradable derivative, and if you have any derivative, for it to be tradable, it should satisfy, its price should satisfy this equation. But I am using the word tradable without defining it, so let me define it quickly. Tradable derivative. So any function f st, so f is price of a derivative and it's of course going to be a function of underlying stock price and time, that is solution to BSM differential equation. Is a theoretical price, is a theoretical price of a derivative that can be traded. When I say traded, it means traded without creating arbitrage opportunity. That can be traded. So traded means without creating arbitrage opportunity in the market. Okay, without creating arbitrage opportunities in the market. Hence, such a derivative would be called as tradable derivative. Okay. Therefore, any derivative whose prices satisfy this differential equation would be called as tradable derivatives. Okay. And if for a derivative the price does not satisfy this equation, then that derivative cannot be traded in the market without creating arbitrage opportunity. It would definitely create arbitrage opportunity. Hence, we call it as a non-tradable derivative. Okay. Let me stop here. Thank you.